Hello everyone, I'm Rocky and I'm again back with the questions of chapter number 4, Chemical Bonding and Molecular Structure, class 11th NCERT. So in this session, we are going to discuss question number 32 and it's on page number 131. So let's see what the question is first and then its solution. The question is distinguish between a sigma and a pi bond. Yeah, sigma and a pi bond. You all are well aware about what is sigma bond and how we represent the pi bond. Pi bond is represented as what we say like this. This is known as a pi bond, or between two atoms, any atom. Suppose A double bond B, any atom. This is a pi bond between the two atoms A and B, and this is the sigma bond between the two atoms. Fine, this is, you all are well aware about it. अच्छा, so sigma bond कैसे form होता है? Sigma bond is formed by the end-to-end overlap of the orbitals, and the orbitals which are involved in this overlapping is SS, SP, or PP. Fine. And sigma bond is a very strong bond, and sigma bond is a very symmetrical also. Fine. The electron cloud in sigma bond is symmetrical about the line joining the two nuclei. And the rotation is very much free in sigma bonds. Lekin coming to the pi bond, pi bonds are formed by the lateral overlapping of the orbitals, and the orbital which are involved in the bond formation is p and p orbital. Pi bond is a weak bond, and the electron cloud in the pi bond is not symmetrical, and the two electron clouds are there in the pi bond which are above and below the plane of the internuclear axis. Fine, and the rotation in pi bond, rotation of the pi bond means restricted. Fine. So now please have a look on the board. I have just given you the overview okay, what is a sigma bond and what is a pi bond. Now please have a look on the board to get about how to write in your notebooks. Fine. So sigma bond, it is formed by end-to-end overlap of orbitals. The orbitals involved in the overlapping are SS, SP or PP. It is a strong bond. The electron cloud is symmetrical about the line. The electron cloud is symmetrical about the line joining the two nuclei. So the electron cloud is symmetrical about the line. The electron cloud is symmetrical about the line joining the two nuclei. It consists of one electron cloud. Sigma bond hota hai, wo it consists karta hai ek hi electron cloud ko. So it consists of one electron cloud which is symmetrical about the internuclear axis, and free rotation about sigma bonds is possible. So rotation, that is free rotation in sigma bonds, are possible. Moving on to the pi bond, it is formed by the lateral overlap of the orbitals. These bonds are formed by the overlap of pp orbitals only. It is a weak bond. The electron cloud in pi bond is not symmetrical. There are two electron clouds lying above and below the plane of atomic nuclei. Kis tarah ke electron clouds hote hain? There are two electron clouds lying above and below the plane of atomic nuclei. So this is one nuclei and this is the another nuclei. Suppose this is A nuclei and this is B nuclei. Fine. And they have been joined by a bond. Fine. Now pi bond jo hota, there are two electron clouds which is above and below the plane of atomic nuclei. So this cloud and this electron cloud, it forms a pi bond. So this is how the pi bond forms. It consists of two electron clouds lying above and below the plane of atomic nuclei. So this is the plane, this is the plane of atomic nuclei, and this is, these are the two electron clouds which are above and below the plane of atomic nuclei. Rotation is restricted in case of pi bond. Fine. So rotation is restricted in the case of pi bond. And now the explanation or the distinguishing between the sigma and pi bond is over. I think there won't be any doubt regarding the differentiation between the sigma and pi bond. But still, if anybody is having any kind of doubt regarding their differentiation, then please do ask it out in the space given below. Well, this brings me to the end of the session, and do not forget to watch the next video for the next session of this chapter, and do subscribe. Till then, take care and goodbye.